four crews alone at sea. Each one cut off in its own world, right in the heart of the action. Is the persistent rotten luck beginning to breed fear?
The next boat will get lost in this fog.
It's got a highway now. Well, we wait for the wave and go, okay?
Commitment is boundless. No matter how much you anticipate, it can be difficult to emerge unscathed from a difficult period.
Be careful!
Shit, I've severed my finger.
That's not good.
The temperature's minus 15. What's the next mission? The other boat seems to be getting through.
There's one just coming. There.
Is it a customer for us?
Yes.
Yes, Papa Jim, Contio. You can come towards us and then we start moving.
When you see the bow of this boat, you'd think she'd been to war.
Yeah, we'll see if she gets as far as us.
Yes, yes, there are bits of ice flying. It helps to have all that mass.
Yes.
A fair amount of paint has come off.
Yes.
I guess it's the cold that has done that.
She gets through the ice well.
Yes, very good. Keep full ahead and follow us.
Moving full ahead, 100%.
Okay. That's very good.
That's great. They're the first ones to say 100%. They look Indian. They're strict and used to following instructions.
I really must go and see what that boat is. Do you have any info about her? It must be a freighter carrying chemicals. Purple Gem Shipping. There are stones there! No, wait, they're going to remove it!
Doesn't want to go.
Push it out the way, Tufik, out the way!
Yeah, yeah.
No, the bottom! The bottom with the sand! Take that one and put it in the bottom. It won't be enough.
After the bad luck of the last few days, a strange calm reigns on board as the crew once more throws the nets into the sea. Even though the sailors have their sea legs, the tangle of huge ropes and cables is a permanent hazard. Someone could be carried off or squashed at any time. Old sea dogs are haunted by the fear of falling in the water. The men on the Cap Saint-Georges are no exception. Everything seems calm at the 32F's base, and yet one team comes rushing back early from practice. The pilot has detected a problem with the helicopter. The mechanics are in countdown. They must get the repair done as quickly as possible, so as to be ready for whatever might happen. This search and rescue machine needs to be ready at all times.
So you're changing it?
Yes, we are.
But I hope we can get it done soon.
In any case, since this is the only SAR machine, we don't have much choice.
So it can be back on alert.
Detonating torque 1214.
Okay, ready, Ronan? Well, it's taking its time, but it is coming.
Do you want a hand or not?
I'm taking it gently so as not to bust the pins. It's not the same as a car. The heart shoulder is 4,000 or 2,000. 2,000 feet below.
Is it ready for assembly?
Yeah. Let's see the other one.
There, sweetie.
Give me the grease, please.
Here, go on.
Can you hold the can?
Okay, go on. I'm holding it. It's not touching there, is it?
On the ice field, everything is under control. Relay pilots have come from neighboring coasts to help the ship sail to the port of Oulu in Finland. Aren't they getting any closer?
It's so cold that the ice is being condensed. The ice is only fragile when it's warmer.
The ice is really dense.
They could walk on it without falling through.
Even an elephant could walk on it.
No, an elephant wouldn't fall through because of its big feet. That's very good. Well done.
Roger. Follow us and you'll get into port safely.
Flight room 32, Gunnar, good morning.
Yes, hello. This is to let you know that the machine is up and running on the forecourt.
Okay, fine. I'll tell the commander and he'll be right there.
Okay, Roger. Thanks.
Thanks a lot.
On the hospital boat, Jose Luis, who suffers from acute dizzy spells, is being kept under observation. He is an experienced fisherman and is finding the time passes slowly. He would like to go back to his boat and his teammates.
Jose, have you got a headache?
No, but it feels like I've got a weight on my head.
I told you the medicine might cause that, okay? I'm going to listen to your breathing. Raise your shirt. Okay. Breathe in and out through your mouth. Everything's fine. Have you been coughing?
No.
Cheers, mate. I don't know. 12?
The jollities are pork pate, veal merengue, spaghetti, amandine for dessert.
Amandine?
Yeah. It's an almond pastry. And this evening, homemade cassoulet.
I'll have some pasta, please.
There you go.
Thanks.
I'll never forget the first time I sailed in the North Atlantic. Somebody recommended that I use patches, the ones for seasickness, which work really well. I used them and I was very satisfied. But then I began to get the side effects from the scopolamine. I couldn't read. I was constipated. My tongue was like a sponge. But I put up with all that. Until the third day, when I removed the lot, so I took them off. They were barely off when I got horribly seasick. It lasted more than 7 days. And after that, it was all right. And since then, I've never been seasick and never had to take anything.
Before, people used to cook at night. One of them would go off. He'd say, "I'll do it." He'd prepare some fish for everyone, and they have another meal at night. And if you stayed at sea for longer, it wasn't just a day or two more. You stayed for a month more.
Oh, right. I get it.
When I was 16, I had a girlfriend. I was away for 119 days. And when I came back, she was married.
I bet she was.
That was when I said to myself that a sailor's life is definitely risky.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Bet you were pissed off.
It's retirement for you soon, eh, Grandad?
What?
You'll retire soon, no more risks.
In a while, yes.
Do you reckon you'll miss the job?
What?
When you miss the job? Retirement, all that. Think you will?
Can't go on forever anyway.
Of course not.
On board the Contio, Jarmo is on his last voyage too. He is soon to retire.
Hello.
Hello.
Looks delicious.
After 40 years' service, Jarmo will be leaving this life he loves with a heavy heart.
Evening all.
Has it already been 6 hours?
It goes fast.
Faster still when you're asleep.
You've had time to do lots of things then?
Yes, I went into the country next door.
So there's water?
Yes, plenty of water. Tonight you'll be able to put on a fourth machine.
So I'll work it out, depending on where we are.
There won't be any time to lose.
Fine, okay. Sleep well then.
You too. Work well. Hope it goes okay, all.
For the man everyone affectionately calls grandfather, it is hard to imagine a new life on firm land. But for the moment, the crew is preoccupied with the holds, which are still empty.
Can you put a film or two on this?
Yeah. What do you want?
Cheers, mate. What do you like?
What I like? I don't care. I've got a hard drive. They're all classified. Tell me what you want.
I hope it's going to be a bit better.
Yeah.
120 crates, 130, 140 isn't bad.
Yeah.
Bump up the number of crates a bit, because we're a bit skint.
Got any films?
Films?
Any good?
Maybe one my brother gave me. Have to look. One or two. I haven't watched it yet. Well, it's bedtime. I told her, I watched The Dictator for 15, 20 minutes. It's crap.
You didn't like it?
Didn't like it at all. I went to sleep. Honestly, it's crap.
Since there's no problems, we're going to watch a film.
You do better to sleep.
Purple came con Theo. You follow the ice channel and please call it and ask if you have problems.
Okay, if we have a problem, we call you back. Is that correct?
That's correct, yes. I will turn now turn to starboard.
Okay, I'm not sure. Thank you.
The emergency center says that if we don't intervene now, the Tanja will run aground within an hour, around 8:30.
I think maybe the ice is drifting to the southwest.
We're very close to the coast. As all sailors know, when night falls, you have to be doubly vigilant. Danger is even more present.
Lucky the ice isn't any thicker, and there aren't any compression ridges.
I'm going to reverse and go in front of the boat. When darkness envelops the 32F, time seems to be suspended, but appearances can be deceptive.
There are three people who've fallen, who got turned over in their boat. Three quarters of an hour ago, right next to the coast at St. Briouac. And, well, apparently someone saw them go over, but nobody saw them come back up.
Daddy Mardos, calling Juan de la Cosa. Good evening. Over.
So, how is that man? Has he finished work? Did you see his finger?
Yes, we put some betadine on it. He's ready to go on board.
We're on our way. Bye for now.
Okay, bye for now.
So you heard. It seems that the man has a deep cut on his left hand. I'll let you get on with the maneuver.
Okay, take care. Christian speaking. Good evening. First, we have to get your boats out and take them into open water. They're drifting with the ice towards the shallows. We're taking the boats to shelter further west of Kokkola in deep water.
All okay at the back?
Yes, you can put it on stop.
Okay, you can go now.
Roger.
Good luck.
Yeah, thanks.
She's well stuck.
Yes, the ice is heaped up. What do you reckon?
I can do it. If I manage to break up that pile. I'll go that way first and go alongside. And the other boat, the Victoria, can come.
Yeah, she can follow on behind.
I'm getting out.
You'll have to go further forward so the ice can move.
That's what I'm doing. I keep maneuvering.
Hello, can you hear me? It's the doc.
Yeah, doc.
Just to check, it's three adults, isn't it?
I think so, he didn't say, but I can ask, yes, if you like.
And how long ago did they fall in the water?
Been a bit more than an hour now. An hour and a half, in case you didn't hear. All three apparently had green clothes and black jackets. Extremely handy.
Round, round, round. Another 1,000 meters to go.
It went.
Well, it was 2,000 meters.
Off we go, then.
Whether young or old, whether your body is exhausted or vigorous, the time for action is any time. No space for doubts or qualms. The men are off into battle against insidious enemies, the cold, the wind, the swell.
Bridge from doctor. Checking communication.
Yes, doctor, receiving you loud and clear. Bridge to all posts. We can begin the maneuver.
Okay, off we go.
Consecrating your life to saving others at sea means knowing how to forget yourself and keep moving forward constantly.
Let's have a closer look.
This isn't going to be easy. The illumination level isn't great. Could be better. We'll see. At least there isn't too much wind. That's something.
Visibility isn't great tonight.
No, it isn't. And the illumination level doesn't give us much scope for action either. Overall, things could be better.
Yes, okay, I've got the command.
So if you see anything, tell me. Have a good look at the coast, on these stones, and in the water, anyway. If there's something in the water.
It'll need some light.
Go, go, go!
Watch out! Watch out!
In the freezing night, the fishermen bring the net up when it's full. They are on deck even with the risk of a breaker. Tirelessly, they have to go through the same dangerous operations. They want to be elsewhere, but keep on nevertheless, under high tension. And now, if you believe in miracles, golden coins pour from the horn of plenty. The shortage is over, and it's raining fish.
Careful later on when we get our man down. Just one person giving orders.
Hang on, just make a loop to hook us on.
What happened?
It's nothing.
The hell it's nothing. First things first. Let's go onto the bridge and I'll protect your hand. Okay. We're going to the bridge. Does it hurt here or lower down?
No, higher up, really.
Oh, I was a bit worried, but it's okay. If the knife hits hard, it makes sense. Okay, bend your finger as far as you can. Good. Now straighten it. Good. Great. Now we can get on.
He didn't want stitches.
No, without stitches, it can't be done.
I could have stitched it myself.
You've done a great job.
I was even going to do four, but...
Yes. We'll clean it all up and maybe put another stitch in, but, well, we'll see.
Yes, because as it is, he can't work.
Yes, I know. Hold that yourself. Gently now. That's a nasty cut. You're playing the hard man. You should have been in the Legion, Manolo. You're taking things amazingly calmly. She's moved.
Yes, she's coming now.
She's going one knot.
I wonder whether the other one will manage to move.
I wonder too. But I'm going to go alongside so we can see. I'll have to go on the other side.
I can take it.
No, I'll take it.
Victoria, Contio, you can start moving when Dinah has passed you. Tania, Conte, you are number one, Victoria number two.
Okay, number one.
Hello, Timo, it's Christian.
What's the Victoria? Is she off?
Looks like it.
The Tanya is stuck again.
Okay, in an hour it would have been grounded. Yes, have a good holiday. Have fun. You too. We can speak again tomorrow morning.
With with strength in solidarity, even alone at sea, enthusiasm is to hand when it comes to once more mending the torn net. Heads don't think about what might happen when bodies are exhausted.
See a body or a jacket in this is no lie.
I can hang on, I can see something.
Go on.
Over there? There's something else over there. I don't know what it is, but it's shiny.
Doesn't seem to be moving.
You should lower the lamp, Thierry.
No, it doesn't look.
No, but it's shiny.
It looks like a boy.
I don't know. I can't see from here.
I can't see very well, but it doesn't look like it.
Alright, Manolo.
Fine.
To start up this stupid compressor, but it wasn't working. I had to take it all apart with my bad finger.
Go on down with Melchior.
That's the boy we saw earlier. I can see, but only within the halo, so I'm moving the halo. There, I can see a body.
Where?
There, vertical. Okay, we're getting warmer. Because if there's one, the others surely aren't too far away.
Surely not.
See the sea rescue boat? It's not flashing anymore. At 2 o'clock. Got it. There's one of them.
What?
Spotted.
Can you see? Roger. No, I'm gonna dazzle him. Okay, we're on. He waved his arms.
He's waving. Yes, okay, I see him. Yeah, sea rescue's going to come.
Okay, got the lamp set up. If he's feeling bad, we have the doctor on board. We must tell him.
Yeah, given his mate's body's in there, that's not great.
Maybe not that one. I don't know.
Yes, not in the dinghy, the big one, the sea rescue launch.
Yeah, now, we mustn't winch up hypothermics.
The what?
People with hypothermia, we mustn't use the winch.
No, no. We're going to let the doctor down, that's all. And then we'll see about picking him up later. Getting ready to let down the doctor.
Roger. But anyway, did you hear? Damien's picked up a third jacket or something like that?
Yeah, we'll have a look anyway. It's no big deal.
He's at the door. I'm ready to take over. He's out, on his way down.
Leaving you the radio, Laurent. He's changing course, going at about 2 knots.
Accroché sur le croc.
40 feet.
se secoue un petit peu et j'aimerais bien que le plongeur vienne la récupérer surtout. Elle est à mi-hauteur toujours. C'est bon, il a pris. Et ben en avant d'eau pour se mettre en avant d'eau. Voilà. Stop pour l'avant et à droite d'eau 2 mètres.
Ils n'entendent rien, tiens.
C'est bon, le plongeur a trouvé. Donc en avant d'eau 1 mètre. Elle est à mettre du pont, stop pour l'avant, elle va arriver sur le pont. Posez.
Did you see the guy waving his arms in the water?
We've managed to save one at least.
He's rare?
Certainly is. It's the first time for me.
I think it's the first time. I've only ever picked up bodies on sea rescue missions.
Door's still open if you want to know.
You like that, don't you? Time to go back.
I don't know. How far's the hospital? Couple of minutes.
2 minutes away.
All right then, leave it open.
Roger.
Good.
Ho, ho.
It's pretty full on. A sleepless night. A hellish spiral. The route is littered with boats caught in the ice. There are more to rescue. It even sometimes happens that the first SOS of the day is sent in the middle of the night.
Do you mind?
What?
If I take the controls?
Of course you can. It's your right as captain.
Go and get a coffee if you like.
You're like our teller, the famous captain of the Uro icebreaker. First you leave it to someone else, and once he's tired, you come along and show him. There. That's how to do it. Like our teller.
Yes, that's it. Yes, like our teller. She's not moving, is she?
Are you going round again?
Yes, or she'll never get moving. The ice is too thick. It's very thick here. What's the other one called? Victoria?
Yes, PF Victoria.
Victoria Condio, if you are able to move so you can go closer to Tanya.
The ice is dense.
She's moving.
What?
She's moving.
Yes, I won not. The purple gem.
What's that? What is it?
The purple gem.
Ah, the purple gem.
They're calling us again.
She's coming from the north.
Icebreaker Contio, Icebreaker Contio, this is motor number purple gem.
Can you answer?
I'll tell them to wait.
Purple gem Contio, stand by, please.
We can land.
There's the halo. There's the halo. That must.
It was pretty jammy though, because the water temperature was 13 degrees. After 2 hours in the water, he must have been nearly off the scale.
It's rare for us to find someone.
He was lucky.
Especially without a waterproof suit. You stay alive for between half an hour, so. So I hope he'll pull through.
We'll soon know, in any case.
They weren't far from the coast.
No.
The problems, when you go out at night, a life jacket just isn't enough.
Oh, no. They didn't go out at night. They called me. I saw them at 5:30.
So it was practically night.
Very nearly.
Even the last survivor did well, I think.
We'll see.
He withstood it. What's more, the worst of it is when there's movement. He sees movement all around him. He must have seen boats go past. We went past above him, no doubt about it. We didn't see anything.
Well, no, there's nothing.
Well, his life jacket was fluorescent, so...
Well, I know, yes.
So if the headlamps don't shine on him, he can't be seen. Just now it was us flying over him and lighting him that made it.
So it reflected?
It reflected off his jacket and we could see him.
Oh, that fast, just for that. You got some cold water?
Okay, thanks.
We could remove that stitch. It's in the wrong place.
Go ahead, remove them. Calm down. Don't touch it. Go on, pull. It doesn't hurt.
Be quiet. That's not the point.
Calm down.
Don't put your fingers on it.
That's it for this evening, Manolo. Tomorrow, we'll take you back to your boat. We'll check for inflammation. For the moment, since it's looking good, we're giving you antibiotics orally, not by injection.
Will you show me your burn, Manolo? Go on, show me. That hasn't improved since the other day. You're in a terrible state, like a peasant. Okay. That'll do.
When at last it's time to rest, the sailors find it hard to part. They go over their fishing trip one last time before going off to bed. Now it's time to tally up. It's time for the first results.
It's like a staircase, that's all. It's the row band.
Three.
It's hard.
3 euros.
It's fine there.
And there you'll see a few drafts and it'll have changed. Why? Because it slips.
A brand new row band.
Yes, but it's hard. What do we bring in? 100 crates?
I reckon, I guess, let's say 113.
In 2 days fishing?
113?
100 at a time.
You count today, Sunday, Monday.
100 crates? That makes...
You'll go home with your 1,800 crates.
Even if you get 1,500, depends how you sell them. Aha, look at the 1,300 we sold them for nearly as much as 1,500.
If there's been no supply, we're okay. If there's been no supply these last few days, we're home and dry.
On the 32F, the tension is subsiding. Unusually, the crew feels the need to speak about what's happened. For these very active people, putting those often repeated actions into words is liberating. Going over the drama is like an exorcism.
It's amazing.
Of course. Now you have to digest. He was really in a state of shock. Hi, how are you?
I didn't even greet you.
Not to worry.
I told the coordination center what happened. No two ways about it. Having you here is 10 times better. Do you realize that? I don't know if he hadn't been there, I don't know what state we would have picked him up in.
Well, we weren't a minute too soon, were we?
35 degrees he was, you said.
Because...
Less than 35?
Yeah. No, it was less. Less? I think our sensor needs checking, because...
The tear is a bit low.
He was below 28, you mean?
It was time we got there. He'd had enough. He was saying, I'm going to die. I'm going to die.
At least he'll be spending Christmas with his family.
That's what he said. He was thinking of the children all the time he was in the water.
I'll bet.
That's what kept him going.
It was time something was done.
Even he said that. He said 5 minutes more and he was gone.
He'd had enough.
He was out of energy. He was going to give up.
He really had no strength left. He was really hypothermic when we picked him up. So, anyway, that's what he said at first. He saw himself dying. But he was. He went through one hell of an ordeal. He wasn't on his own, and unfortunately, his mates...
didn't have the same fate.
Not the same outcome.
Did the guys see if he'd seen us going past several times or not?
He said we were a long way off. And he said he shouted, but we didn't hear him. Hardly surprising, but well, he was in a state of shock. But, yeah, we weren't far off, and...
How old was he?
39. When I got there, he was really in shock. He'd been to get the two guys that died. One of the two others didn't know how to swim, so he was floating more or less with the clothes and with the can that he gave him. But well, it went a bit. You see, the one who couldn't swim had already pushed his head under the water 3 or 4 times. The guy's trying to cope, trying to save himself for starters. He's trying to help his friend who can't swim. He was holding a telephone more or less at arm's length because he was hoping we'd be able to find him by triangulation. It was really time we arrived.
We'll stay as we are. We'll be there soon.
While some are still upset, others keep a cool head in the middle of a high-risk maneuver. Christian, the captain of the Contio, a first-class super icebreaker, must get as close as possible to those steel monsters with its 9,000-ton movement, capable of breaking ice more than a meter thick.
Going round really is the best solution.
Yes, it's the best we can do.
You are stuck, okay. Okay, you start moving, nice. Then keep full head.
Nah, it was good piloting for a bit.
He's really much better.
Can I take over?
Yes, go on. The other one's stuck too.
You can't see a thing. It's really difficult.
Victoria's stuck, okay, thank you. Dani, ja Conti.
Yes.
I will go to assist Victoria.
Okay.
You can try proceed westwards if possible. From this position where I am now.
He can always try.
Yes, he can try as hard as he likes. But he has little chance of success.
This is the place where the Tanja got stuck earlier. It's going to take the whole damn evening. With this lot, we will have earned our wages.
After having seen the difficulty and the sailors' working conditions, who work themselves into the ground to catch fish, it's truly a miracle to see them at the end of the night still with a spirit and a will that would have deserted me. And in spite of bodies worn and exhausted by a job that only rarely allows them to live a normal life. Lots of nice cash in my purple pocket.
Be sure to observe the safety distance.
They're about 30 meters ahead.
I haven't done that for a while, at night.
I'd really like to have an hour to talk to my grandfather and explain everything I do.
It's in the water, 2 meters ahead.
They've run into each other. They didn't keep a safe distance apart.
I must have hit it with my arm because I'm sure I centered it.
Carry on the good work and take care.
Look, there's a hole.
A little hole, yes.
Gentlemen, the end is near.
One more day like that, eh, grandfather?